folks. This is D-Vang once again. We've got the Outlaw Joseph Scott's episode 79. This is going to be a bit of a long one here. This is the second mission for the Scafford Gang. If you've been kind of keeping up with some of the comments, or maybe you haven't, but one of the viewers named Solon suggested that we try to increase the difficulty for Joseph a little bit, and so I'm going to go ahead and try in this episode to use some higher threat cards, and let's see how Joseph handles that and what kind of excitement he can get into. So let's take a look at the board. Enjoy. And here we are again. Here's the board, and this is Scafford Gang mission number 2, entitled Most Wanted. There's a hefty bounty on Colonel Scafford and his Scafford gang, having robbed just about every bank and train in the area over the last few months. Following all the evidence and rumors have led you to the mine, to this mine. Their hideout must be inside here somewhere. You just need to find it and bring them to justice. And, of course, not stumble into too many traps along the way. Yeah, and for the reward that we're going to get for them. So the setup is the standard mine entrance as normal, so we've got that here. The goal, scour the mines looking for the Scafford Gang's secret hideout. So when the hero posse marker reaches the number 8 on the depth track, we've found the hideout and can confront Colonel Scafford and his gang. Special rules, whenever the heroes find a clue icon, we've stumbled onto the outlaw trap set by the gang. Before resolving the rest of the exploration token, roll once on the outlaw trap chart to see what kind of trap goes off. Note that rerolls on this chart may not be rerolled using grit. So, outlaw trap. So we've got a trapped beast, a spiked pit, a shotgun tripwire, rigged dynamite, rocky collapse, and defective trap. And it does not go off. The objective, find the hideout. When the space marked 8 is reached by the hairy posse marker, we found the entrance. You ignore any door gate icons on the token for the map pile just placed, as it has only one exit leading to the final objective room, which is the campsite tile, if you have it, if you have the caverns of cinder. Otherwise, it's just going to be kind of a random tile. That's not a passage. Do not place an exploration token on that objective tile. Before the hero can enter the hideout, complete any encounters, attacks, and outlaw traps on the current exploration token map tile. Models may not enter a space of the objective room map tile until any fight from the exploration token is complete. The end of the first turn in which one or more heroes are on the objective room map tile, a showdown with the Scafford Gang begins. Reveal all growing dread cards in the stack as normal, and the heroes must face an epic threat selected from only those that include Colonel Scafford. Once Colonel Scafford and all other enemies have been defeated, the heroes have successfully completed the mission. Each hero gains 2d6 times $100 as bounty for stopping Colonel Scafford and his gang. On a failure, each hero must roll once on the mutation chart as they are knocked out and left for dead in the corrupting mines. So, this is what we're looking at. Now, as I had mentioned in the intro, Solon had requested that we try a little up in the difficulty a little bit. So I am actually going to do that. What I'm going to do is, Joseph's now going to be facing medium threats instead of low. And I think I will try an epic threat. We'll actually see Colonel Scafford in action. So no lieutenant, actual Colonel Colonel Scafford. So we'll give that a try. To offset that, instead of giving 2 elite abilities, or actually I had been doing 3, but the rulebook says 2 elite abilities for 7th level, or for 8th level posse, I'm going to only give 1 elite ability, which is this level 7 posse, and we'll see if that balances the difficulty out a little bit, and we'll see if that's too hard or too easy, and I can adjust the elite abilities from there. You know, maybe have no elite abilities. But we're still on the brutal side of things. But that is the plan for this mission. So let's see how it goes. Otherwise, it's a pretty straight up adventure. And we start by holding back the darkness. A 4 will fail, so that's not a good start. Then Joseph rolls to move. Well, at least he gets a 6, so he can get some movement in. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, which is enough for him to find the first room, which is a switch curve. Okay, switch curve. And we have a token, which is a growing dread, an encounter, and a clue icon. So the first thing we do is we resolve the clue icon. Because that is a trap. And it is a 2. Oh, don't forget to move that. Which is a spiked pit. One random hero, that would be Joseph, obviously, stumbles as the floor falls below falls away. Make an agility 6 plus test. If passed, gain 20 experience. If failed, take 2d6 wounds, ignoring defense. So, Joseph has... I think it was a 6 agility, so he does get a 6, so he passes. He avoids the trap. Okay, that gets us a growing dread card. Boom. And an encounter card. Which is, make sure these are shuffled. A lucky find. The room is filled with broken trinkets and rusty scraps. There may be something useful under all this, if you can find it. Luck 6 plus, draw a loot card. If no hero passes, your luck has run out, an ambush attack. Alright, well, Joseph has a 5 luck, so he's actually pretty good at that. Need a 1-6. He fails. You know what? I'm going to spend a grit. Ugh, still no luck in the dice, so used a grit and, boy, and gets an ambush attack. And that uses that's it for that token. So he is ambushed by, well, these are medium threats, so well, let's see what he's ambushed by. The card is, he's ambushed by a Darkstone Hydra. Mr. Darkstone Hydra, coming out of the woodwork. there. Poor Joseph. Alright. And the Hydra's ability is... You'll remember only one. We're only doing one. Is a 4. Okay, so normal Darkstone Hydra is extra large here, obviously. Initiative 7. It's got Terror 3. Darkstone Radiation 2. So then your move adjacent is going to take Corruption hits, so that's going to suck. Can move through targets. He regenerates multiple heads. If he's at 20 health or less, he's minus 1. So he loses combat as he gets more damaged. And we can gain some Darkstone. So obviously 3 combat dice doing 7 damage each. Bunch of move, not too bad to escape, 3 plus melee. Alright, so, and ability number 4 is an extra head. So he's 1 extra combat die. That's potential 7 more points of damage. He's initiative 7 and he will be going first. So... starts off horribly. Alright, dangerous. Alright, hold back the darkness. An 8 will succeed. Well, that's some good news. So the Hydra's gonna go first. So he has 4 dice, hitting on 3. Luckily, 6s don't do anything, so. Alright, so 3 hits that Joseph has to defend against. So. 3 defense rolls of 5 plus. Boom. He'll spend his last grit. Blocks another one. Good. So that's 7 wounds. Joseph has to save against with his armor. Woo, that was pretty bad. Luckily, he's got the tribal armor, so he gets to reroll all these. And that is better. So he takes 3 wounds. Not bad. That is not bad. He is out of grit, though. Okay, now it's Joseph's turn. So first off, he has Terror 3. He saves 2 of them, so he's going to take 1 point of sanity damage. Then we have the Darkstone Radiation. He gets his move first in the box. All right, you know what? We'll try to get around to the other side of him. We'll try to move a little bit. So 5 plus, reroll with Bandana. Nope, so he's there. And he does end his movement adjacent, so 2 corruption hits, so he has to take 2 saves, which he fails both. So that's going to be 2 points of corruption, which is going to suck. This is going to be nasty. Joseph will be maybe getting some mutations here. Maybe. We'll see. We'll see if I can kill him in one round. He's got 25 health, so... That's not too horrible. So, Joseph gets to shoot. So he's got 4 dice for each pistol. Okay, and hit it on 4s. Okay, well that's pretty good. He gets his 3 rerolls. And 1 more hit. It's nice. Alright, so 1 and 1. Okay, rolling damage. Now he has a defense of 3. So Joseph is +2. So -1 on each die. Blah, that's pretty horrible. So those do nothing. So -1 on each die. So, excuse me. So 4, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 14, and then Justin's going to use both his void assemblies. Again, minimum, jeez, for 6 more. So that is 20 wounds. But horrible rolling for damage. Not enough to kill the Hydra in one turn. So it is the next turn. So let's hold back the darkness. A 5 will fail. That gets us a darkness card, which is Encroaching Shadows. Hold back darkness -1. Heroes are now +2 move. Interesting. Not a good one to get this early in the game, though. And then the Hydra. So the Hydra's going to heal a D3. So he only heals 1. That's a D6 if there's more than 2 heroes. And then he gets to attack Joseph. Wow, alright, so Joseph had some bad luck doing damage, but the Hydra only hit once. Joseph gets his defense, which fails, and then we've got 7... armor saves, block, free reroll, doesn't block. So it's going to be 4 more points of damage to Joseph. Puts him up to 7 wounds. And then it is Joseph's turn. So first he has his terror, takes 1 point of sanity. Okay, Joseph rolls to move. Decent movement. Let's see if we can get away from this guy. No. Reroll the bandana. No. So he's still stuck there. So he's going to take two corruption hits. So we need two more. And he fails both of them. That's two more points of corruption. That's 4 points of corruption. That is not good. And then Joseph hopefully should be able to finish this guy off. Of course, I had to say something and get some pretty pathetic hits, but that's still, well, I guess I shouldn't jinx myself. We are down 6 wounds. I need to do at least 6 wounds. Of course, now I get some 5s and some 4s. That is enough to be 6 wounds. There's 2, 5, so 3 hits is enough to kill Mr. Hydra. Joseph will heal 1 wound, I guess. Yeah, he had 2 sanity damage and 7 wounds. He gets to recover 1. We'll take another wound. And he gets a loot card. So, but the worst thing is he's got 4 corruption. Loot card is blood money, d6 times 25. And 25. Not going very well here. Alright. Hold back the darkness. A 10 will succeed. Joseph gets to move. Now he gets a 1. Now that he can move and really needs to get moving. But we are plus 2 move. Well, so let's go ahead and take the 1. Let's get a grit back. And so let's move 3. 1, 2, 3. And let's hold back the darkness again. Or we need an 8 so now because of that card. So 7 fails. And that will push that up. Joseph rolls to move. Well, he gets another 1, and that's another 3. So we'll go 1, 2. That gets him a second grit. At least he's prepared with grit for this. Let's see what the next card is. It is a waterfall room. All right. There is the waterfall room. And there's a token, which is, there's 1 exit, which is a gate. And an attack. So the exit is to the left. And he is attacked by D3 Void Hounds. So we have 1 Void Hound, and his elite ability is a 3. But it's just an attack. Not that it makes a big difference, because he can certainly get to me in 1 move here. Alright, so the Void Hound. except he always starts from ambush as his special ability. So, and one of their special abilities, defense is equal to current initiative, so his defense is going to be 4, because that's when Joseph goes. And he's got a special ability, elite ability of 3, which is Maul. Anytime a hero takes 5 or more wounds from a Void Hound's melee, that hero must also discard a sidebag token. But let us hold back the darkness. Double ones. That is, I do believe, an ambush attack. And he's ambushed by one harvester. And back up on a roll of d6 on a 1 or 2, he adds a second harvester. No. So there is also a harvester who is in ambush. Interesting. Poor Joseph. Lead ability for the harvester is a 1, which is reinforced plating, so it gives him 3 more health. That's not too horrible. They will both go before Joseph. So let us, that was holding back the darkness, so the Void Hound goes first, so he's got 8 dice. Hitting on 3s. Nothing, there's only 1, so nothing too horrible for that. Each does 2 points of damage, so. Yep. Okay, and then Joseph gets his defense. Sorry, that was. I don't know, this is his defense roll. Box 2. Okay. And then each of these is 2 dice, so it's going to be 8 wounds for his armor. There's armor save. He blocks 4 of them. So, you know what? I'll take the 4. I'm going to take the 4 wounds, because if I had taken the enough from the mauls, if I had taken 5, I probably would have used his reroll for his armor, but since I didn't, let's just take the 4 wounds. All right, now the harvester gets to go. Now the harvester, if he rolls doubles on his melee to hit rolls, it does a free extra attack that does something. He has 2 dice, basically, hitting on 3. No, all right, well 2 hits, each doing 6 wounds. So Joseph gets 2 defense. No, let's save the grit. He's got wounds here. So that's 6 each. So 12 damage. Armor saves. Ooh, good armor. Good armor. 6 wounds. So, with a 5 plus save, and he saved half, I will take that. and won't spend a grit, as I will end up spending a grit to shoot and hopefully kill these guys. That is the plan. Now, Joseph does have 15 wounds. We do have to keep that in mind. He is halfway down. But it's Joseph's turn. So, roll to move. Actually, let's take a check. Okay, so there's no terror for any of these guys. No start of turn effects. Joseph does not get another grit. I could back up or move. Do I want to go? You know, I'd really rather not go into another world. You know, I know I do. I know I get the +1 damage for being in the other world because of the authority of Otar. But the other extra effects, you know, if I go to Cinder, then I have to worry about clothing. I just got extra effects that I don't really want to keep track of. So let's go ahead and try to escape here. So the worst escape is a 5 plus from the Void Hounds. So let's see if he can escape. He can't escape, so he's kind of stuck there anyway. It was worth a shot. Try to, you know, get back over here. All right. So Joseph gets his rolls. Yeah, and he's gonna need a grit. So we'll spend a grit to re-roll those. I need to try to take these guys out fairly quickly, and the reroll is absolutely horrendous. Okay. Well. 6 hits. So do I take out the Hound or do I take out the Harvester? Let's take out the Harvester. Yeah, we'll try to take out the Harvester. So he's got a defense of 5 and 9 wounds. Joseph is a 3. So he's got one for his Dark Stone Bullets, 2 for his skills. So he's minus 2 on each die. And I need a 9. Total. You know what? Let's save. We'll save 2 hits out. And see what we get. So remember, minus 2 on each die. Those aren't good. So a 4 and a 5. We use 1 avoid assembly. And so add 6, we'll save to the red one. And that is enough to kill the Harvester, because we get to add on that damage. The armor has already been subtracted off of that. So that allows Joseph to heal 1 point for killing him. And then he's got 2 hits left and a Void Assembly, which he might as well spend for the Void Hound. So the Void Hound is a defense of 4, so Joseph is minus 1 on each die, except for the Peril die. And this is for the blue. Obviously this adds to the blue. So minus 1 is a 4, and this becomes a 5 and a 4 is a 9. He's only got 8 health, so that is enough to kill the Void Hound. I'll let Joseph heal another wound. Joseph gets to recover 2 for catching his breath, so we'll take 2 wounds off. And then he gets 2 loot cards because he had two threats, basically. The depth event and ambush and the other card. So he's got a draw gear card and $50. The gear card is executioner pistol. All right, well, obviously it's something that he can consider selling. If he gets to keep it, so obviously he has no more, he can't hold anything else. So that is that. I'll put this loot card away. And it is on to the next turn. And now we need to start the turn. So let us hold back the darkness. A five will fail. That gets us another darkness card. Demonic force. Demon enemies are now +1 combat. And then Joseph needs to roll the move. Alright, we'll take the 6. Remember, we're coming over here because I don't want to go through the gate. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then we get +2 move. 1, 2. So that gets him all the way over there. And able to look through, and we find a standard rail tunnel. Okay. Standard rail tunnel. With a token, which says he's attacked, and it is a clue. And that should, by the way, we should be 1, 2, 3. And, all right, so first we need to figure out what the trap is. So I'm going to roll a d6, a 3. So the trap of 3 is a shotgun tripwire. 1 random hero. Snap the string at their feet. Make a luck 6+ test. Okay, so Joseph has 5 dice for a luck 6+ test. Ooh, and he passes that in spades. All right. So it gives him 20 experience. and does not give him much wounds.
So he is attacked by
a Night Terror and one low threat card. And
low threat card is a Peril Dice of Hellbats.
So 6 Hellbats. Okay, and this is totally old school. Oh, and I should say there are 2 exits on this icon, so both those are actually exits. So we have the Night Terror. I guess farthest would be over here. And then the Hellbats. This is totally old school. New enemies here. That's probably the best way to take a look there. And we need to know what the abilities are. So we have, for the Night Terror, he has a 4, and the Hellbats have a 4 as well. The ability 4 for the Night Terrors is Hulking plus 1 defense. And the ability 4 for the Hellbats is Void Injection. Any hero that takes 1 or more wounds also takes a corruption hit. Blah. Okay, and there are 6 of them. Okay, this is going to be bad. This is going to be mutation time. Alright, well, not much Joseph can do about it. They will all get to go first. They all get to go first. So let's hold back the darkness for the new turn. A 5 will fail. Oh, and by the way, the Hellbats have an additional... Oh, actually, both of these are demons, so they get an additional combat die. Which is not good. Alright. So that fails, pushes the darkness up. And then we move. So, the Hellbats are going to surround Joseph. And get all 6 of them. All 6 of those lovelies are on him. They have 4 dice each. And I do kind of need to roll them separate because these are going to be corruption hits for each one. So we'll kind of start here, work our way around. They hit on 3s. Joseph also, for every hit, also he's going to take a horror hit. So we have to keep that in mind as well. Okay, so that is 4 hits for that one. That is 4 hits for that one. That is 3 hits for this one. Don't really have to keep them all set. One more die. So 2 hits for that one. 4 hits for that one. And 3 hits for that one. Alright, so not very good for Joseph, but let's just see what happens. Alright, defense. So because I'm probably going to use the grit, these are all considered rolling at the same time. Joseph gets his defense, so good. That blocks 2, that's good to see. And that blocks 1. Okay, over here, blocks 1. Over here, blocks 1. Over here, blocks 3. Excellent. And over here, blocks 2. Okay. So, now the Night Terror is large, so he's going to push those guys aside. The question is, do I bother to, roll these? You know what, I think I will, simply because of all the corruption hits that they're going to give. And these are all horror hits that Joseph has to take. So he will spend his grit to reroll these. Let's take them, reroll them. If he gets knocked out by the Night Terror, he gets knocked out by the Night Terror. But that's...
I have to roll them separately again. Alright, hold on. Okay, I have reset the dice back to where they again completely forgot that I needed to keep track of, you know, how many actual Hellbats get hits in. So, spent the grit, so I'm going to reroll all these. Blocks one, good. Blocks one, so that's good. Blocks both. Go, Joseph. Okay. Blocks that one. Ooh, so close. All right. So that's what we got. So I might as well roll my sanity or my willpower saves first right now. So it's so horror hit here is blocked. Takes one, two. Okay, and that's four, two sanity each. So that's four sanity. That he takes damage there. Now we need to do damage for each of these. And their ability was one or more wounds must discard a dark stone, or sorry, takes a corruption hit. So and it's two damage each. So we can just add an extra die to each one of these. So damage from this fellow on armor. Okay, block one, so that's one. Doesn't block, oh, blocks one. Doesn't block any. And blocks one. Okay, well that will be four corruption hits. Okay, but I think, so I have the armor reroll, the free armor reroll, but I think I might need that for the Night Terror. So, I'm going to go ahead and take that. Let's do the corruption hits first. Oh, actually, it doesn't matter. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, that's going to be 7 wounds that Joseph takes. So he's at 18 wounds, so a little over half. And then he takes 4 corruption hits. Takes 2 corruption, blocks 2. So 2 corruption. So 1 puts him to 5, 2, so he's got 1, and he gets mutated. So we look at the mutation chart, it's a D36, so we'll say purple is the first digit, red is the second. We have a 2, 5. Void boils, he's minus 2 health, but plus 1 max grit. Not bad. That's actually probably one of the best mutations in the chart. Okay, so the minus 2 health obviously sucks, drops him down to 31. But the plus 1 max grit is actually pretty nice, especially since he's got the eye patch, which gives him grit up to his max grit. Means it's going to come in useful every session, because I've used the eye patch just about every session. Alright, initiative 4, the Night Terror gets to go, and he can move 5. I think he's still got enough. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Displaces that fellow. Boom. Alright, so he has 5 dice. Hitting on fives. He has terror that does 3d10 to each, and each combat hit counts as 2 hits. So the 5 dice hitting on fives. 1. So that actually makes 2 hits. Okay. So Joseph gets his defense, doesn't block either one. And that's 4 damage. for each hit. And his armor blocks 2. He gets his free reroll. Yeah, he's only blocks 1 more, so it's going to be 5 more wounds, which puts him at 23 of 31. So 8 left, I guess. Alright, then, hey, it's finally Joseph's turn. So, first thing is, he has Terror 2. So, 2 willpower saves, saves 1, fails 1. It does 3 sanity damage, though, so 1, 2, 3, so he's up to 9 out of 22 sanity. And then Joseph rolls to move, not that he can go anywhere. He does get a 1, which he will take, because yes, he cannot go anywhere. And I think we need to kill some hellbats, because I don't want more corruption hits. So let's go for that. Shoot him up. Pretty well. Guess it's not that bad a shooting. There are 3. Do I use the grit? No, I'm not going to use the grit. Because I'm going to use the grit conceivably for something. I think I'll save it up. Oh, good thing I did not use it. Because that is just perfect. So I have 3 extra hits with the red, 1 extra hit with the blue. That is a lot of shots. Alright, so the Hellbats. Defense of 3. Joseph does 2 damage, 1 for the bullets, 1 for his skill, so he's minus 1 on each die. They are a health of 2, which means Joseph needs a 3 or better on a die to kill them. So we'll start with him, and a 2 will do 1 point of damage. Because he's minus 1 on each die. Alright, we'll hit an unwounded one. Really? Really? It's gonna be like this. Okay? Blue die. Oh my goodness, look at that. 3 in a row were 2s. Can you believe that? Let's do another unwounded one. Bounces. We'll hit that same one again. Oops, that needed to be in the box. Alright, well that finally kills one. And we'll heal Joseph. Jeez, I don't even know what. Oh, I guess we'll do a wound. We'll hit this unwounded one. Well, there's a dead. We'll do a wound. All right. Well, 6 hits left. Well, you know what? Let's go back. Anything but a 1. Hit him, anything but a 1. There's a 6. We'll hit him, anything but a 1. Alright, so that heals Joseph for 3. Guess we'll make it 3 wounds. And that leaves 3 dice left for Mr. Night Terror, who has 20 health and a defense of 4. So Joseph's plus 2, plus 3, 4. So he's minus 1 on each side. Doesn't really matter. We'll throw all of these on him. And you know what? Per fight, we'll also use each void assembly. You know what? I'm going to save one of these out just in case. So I've got 1 from each pistol and using the void assemblies on each one. See if I can get 20. If I'm minus 1 on each side, 5, 10, 15, 20, so I conceivably could if I roll really, really well. Pretty good, but not quite enough to hit 20, I don't think. So we've there got a 7 and 10, 17. Okay. And this needs, so this needs a, because this is a separate hit, needs a 4 or better, because it's minus 1 on the die, 17, and I need a total of 20, so I need 3, so 4 or better. No, it bounces and does nothing. So, 17 points of damage, 15, 16, 17, but not enough, to kill, him. With what was left. Man, all those twos for damage, wasting that. Good news is Joseph won't be getting a lot more corruption. Alright. Next turn though, hold back the darkness. A 5 will fail. That gets us another growing dread card. And, alright, then the bat gets to go, so the bat's going to come over here, kapow, he's going to take his shot, so he's got 4 dice, hitting on 3s, so 3 hits, Joseph gets his defense, doesn't block any, you know what, I don't really care, I don't want to use the grit, so 3 dice, that's 2 damage each, so 6 armor saves, blocks 1, so that's going to be another 5 wounds, puts him to 23, and he takes a corruption hit, so he needs to make a save, which he fails, so that gets him another corruption point, he's back up to 2 corruption. And I didn't make the horror hits. How many was that? 2, 4. What was that, like 6? Sorry, 1, 2, 3. We'll say 4 hits, I think it was. Willpower save. He saves 1, so 2, 4, 6 sanity damage. Puts him up to 15 of 22. Rough for Joseph. And then the Night Terror. Night Terror gets 5 dice. Hitting on 5s. Ouch. Okay. Well, that's 4 hits. Doubled, because each one counts as 2 hits. So that is 8 hits. Just to get this defense, which is where I'm going to spend my grit to reroll these. Only blocks 1 more. Ouch. Okay, they are 4 damage each. So, let's see, we've got 5, 10, 15. 20 wounds. Armor saves. Pretty good. And then his free reroll for the tribal armor. Locks, only a couple more. I think this is enough to knock him out. Which is going to be fine, I think. So 5, 10, 10, and he has 23. So yeah, that makes 33, and that is enough to knock him out. Boom, he uses 1 revive. Okay. Well, it is now Joseph's turn. So first he has terror. Blocks 1, so that's 3 more, or 3 sanity. I just can't say more because he just refreshed. And then Joseph rolls to move. Oops, in the box. Okay, he could attempt to move, and I think he might because I want to try to get exploring because time is running out. So Let's see. The worst escape is the Night Terrors at 5+. So there's one. Nope, he's stuck. He is stuck there. So let's shoot. And that gets us a whole lot of crap. Wow, that was pretty horrible. Luckily, when you revive, you do restore one grit. So, because I don't think three hits might be enough. And I do get my reroll, so I'm actually not gonna spend my grit, even though that's a really horrible thing. I think it might be a waste. I will get one extra die because of that. But I do get three rerolls as it is. So let's just roll three. There we go, three more hits. And one more. So, let's roll against the, we'll send two dice against the bat. So I need anything but double ones. Okay. And the rest of these against that fellow, I need to do 15, 16, 17, so I need to do three wounds. And I am minus one, right? Or minus, yes, minus one on each die. That is plenty. All right. So that will heal Joseph for two and finish them off. So that gets rid of two sanity points of damage. He gets to catch his breath, which gets rid of the last point of sanity damage that he has. And then he gets a loot card. For 25. And I believe he gets a second one because even though that was one card, it's actually two cards. So, and he gets 50. So, alright, hold back the darkness. Just fighting for time. A 7 is not good enough. Joseph rolls to move. I could really use the grit, but I need time as well, so let's go ahead and we'll just move. 1, 2, 3, 4. We'll look through, and we find the blast room. Track up. Okay, we get a token which says there's one exit and an encounter. So the exit is to the left, and there is an encounter. Which is an ancient riddle. The way forward is blocked by an unseen force and a riddling stone. Cunning 6 plus test. Right, Joseph's cunning is 4. And he succeeds, so he gains 30 experience. And the way forward is passed. Alright. Joseph still has 1, 2, 3, 4 more rooms to go in, which is unfortunate. So let us hold back the darkness. A 6 will fail. That gets us another darkness card, which is a power of the void. Void enemies are +1 combat. Joseph rolls to move. All right, that will get him. Get him there, and we'll go ahead and look through, and we find a long passage. Actually, I think at this point, patches would be nice. That way I don't have to potentially get more attacks. All right. Hold back the darkness. 7 will fail. Oops, and that moves the track one more. 7 will fail, so that pushes that darkness up to 9. Okay, Joseph rolls to move. Double 2s. Oh, really? That's going to be not quite enough. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, hold back the darkness. 7 will fail again, because he needs an 8. Dark discard. Screams of the Damned. Each hero takes 3 horror hits. Also roll a d6 for each token in your side bag. Alright, so Joseph takes 3 horror hits, not a d6. Saves 1, so he's going to take 2 points of sanity damage. Alright, so he has 2 herbs. On a 1 or 2, it's stolen. So he loses 1 herbs. He's got a tequila, is fine, and he's got a tonic, is fine. So he lost 1 herb token. Unfortunate, but could have been worse. Okay, and then Joseph rolls to move, because that was the hold back the darkness. Got a darkness card. All right, well, Joseph will plunk his 1, and what do we get? We have a rail tunnel. All right, and we get a token, encounter exploration, which says 1 exit, 2 encounters. So the exit is to the left, and then we have 2 encounters. Here we go. We have a broken lift, and we have a flooded passage. So the broken lift says, choose. An old mining lift flies far into the room. You might be able to get it working. Choose. Try to repair the mining lift, making a cunning test, or make a luck test to avoid getting attacked by tentacles. So cunning 6 plus, you know what, I'm going to make the luck test. I don't want to risk, granted, if I make the cunning test, I can get a loot card. But if he fails, he's attacked, and I would rather not be attacked. So, and my luck will be slightly better. So he's got 5 luck, needing a 5. And he doesn't get it. Good lord. Okay, spending his grit. And still doesn't roll a 5. Wow. Okay. Well, Joseph is now attacked by a peril dice of tentacles. So 6. 6 tentacles. And we'll get to that in a minute. This is also a flooded passage. So all movement costs an extra 1 move for space. And then roll a d6. A 4. Hungry dead rise up. Ambush attack by 2 peril dice of hungry dead. So 9 hungry dead and 6 tentacles. Although the hungry dead are an ambush attack. Tentacles are not in ambush. They are going to pop up over here. And then the hungry dead are going to swarm around Joseph, popular fellow that he is. Okay, well, oh, and the 1 ability for the tentacles is a 5, and the 1 ability for the hungry dead is a 1. So the 5 for the tentacles is drag. So here, wounded by tentacles, move to a random empty space adjacent to that tentacle. All right, that's probably something I'm going to forget, but I'll try to remember.
The Hungry Dead get plus 2 health for that elite ability number 1. So he's going to have a hard time slogging through this. Good news is the tentacles can't get to him because of the Hungry Dead. that's about all I can say for good news. And Joseph gets to go before the Hungry Dead. So, hold back the darkness. The problem is, I'm going to run out of darkness. Double fours. Maybe not. Falling rubble. So, he takes a d6 hits. 6. So, 6 defense. Ooh, he blocks 4. Just used up all of my good dice. Armor blocks 1, so he takes 1 wound from the rubble. Well, the good news is it didn't move the trap. Alright, so the tentacles. Tentacles cannot move through stuff, so tentacles are going to just pile up here, go in, writhing and wiggling over there, crazy as they are. Alright, Joseph gets to go. So Joseph is adjacent to 2, 3, 4, 5 Hungry Dead. So he has to make 5 willpower saves. He saves 3, so that gives him 2 points of sanity damage, because they are fear 1. And then Joseph rolls to move, does not get a 1, so this does not have grit. And then he gets to shoot. Try to kill some Hungry Dead. Wow, with some horrible rolling. He has no grit unless I want to use my eye patch, which I would rather not use this early on. So, well, I get some 2 more hits. Total 4 hits. Alright, well, the Hungry Dead have a 5 defense. Joseph is a 3. So, the minus 2 on each die, and he needs a 4. So, okay. He needs a 4 to kill him. Or, sorry, needs a 6 to kill him. And they've, because they've got 4 hit points each. I'll go ahead and roll them one at a time. A 6 means a 6 will kill one. A 5 will do, and they'll do damage on it. We'll shoot the ones in the back first. We said I was minus 2, correct? Yep. So, 1 point of damage. I'll shoot that one. 5, that does 3 wounds. Okay. Let's shoot that one. Does nothing. Let's shoot that wounded one. See if I can get some. Alright, of course, then I would hit the 6, but at least that's one that was not as wounded. And that will heal Joseph for 1. We'll take a sanity. And, there we go. Now the Hungry Dead get to go, so he will push in. Now, Void, so the tentacles have an additional combat, but the Hungry Dead have not been buffed, at all. So they have 2 dice each, and there we said there was 5 on him. That's 10. Hitting on 4s. Okay. So, defense. That's 2. And they are 5 damage each. So we add 4 for each of these dice. That's 20 wounds against his armor. Does a pretty, as usual, his armor does a pretty decent job, and we get the free reroll from the armor, because obviously the tentacles are not going to get to him yet. The reroll didn't do so hot, though, so 9 wounds. Joseph takes. Okay, puts him up to 10 wounds. And now hold back the darkness. An 8 is just enough to succeed. He's right at the cusp of moving into the next level. He still needs 3 more rooms, which is going to be rough. Tentacles cannot move, so Joseph rolls for his movement. Okay, double 3s doesn't give him a grit, and he can't move through them. He does have to make his 5 fear tests, and he only blocks 2, so that's going to be 3 sanity damage, which will put him up to 6. All right, and now it is Joseph's shooting phase. See if we can kill a few more hits. Ah, much better. Okay, so we'll reroll these. He has 1 more reroll that he can do. There we go, 1 more hit, and 2 more hits with the red dice. The red gun. All right. So, kind of the same thing, so let's shoot him. Okay, so that does 3 wounds. That's pretty good. I hate it. I do kind of hate it when the Hungry Dead get extra health, just simply because they get such a high defense. Let's shoot him. Okay, that does 1 wound. All right, let's hit that guy again. We're -1 is 3, so that is enough to kill him. In fact, let me knock him down. I'll get to them in a minute. Him. Okay, let's shoot that guy. -1. That's enough. Knock him down. Shoot that guy. Bounces. Sorry, I'm actually -2 on each die. I meant. That 3 was still enough. Alright, so that does get rid of all 3 of them, which will heal Joseph for 3, and I guess I will take wounds because the tentacles will be coming shortly, because Joseph has 3 shots left which have to go into those. So let's shoot that one. Ooh, a 6. Finally, that will actually kill him and heal Joseph. Let's take another wound. We'll shoot him. Another 6. Well, after having a string of bad rounds, well, you know, that's kind of the way luck goes in this game. Oh, all right. So two shots left. Let's hit a tentacle. So the tentacle is a defense of 3. Joseph is a 2. So -1 on each die. And he needs a 6. You know what? Actually, I have 1 on each. So I'm going to do 1 on each, and I'm actually going to use my void assemblies. Or do I use it to overcome Hungry Dead? The Hungry Dead do get to attack. No, let's do the tentacles. I am worried about the tentacles. You know what? For some reason, I was thinking the tentacles had a higher initiative. The tentacles are actually going to go first. Before the Hungry Dead. So, yeah, I definitely need to get rid of the tentacle. So, I was -1, and I need 5 wounds. So, this would be a 4, and 4 is 8, so that will definitely kill a tentacle. And let's shoot this other tentacle, and that will be enough. 5 and a 3 is 8. That is enough to kill that tentacle. So that is 2 more. Let's do 2 more wounds. And I used his void assemblies for this fight. Alright, and then the tentacles get to go. So, tentacle here. Tentacle here. And you know, the Hungry Dead got first go that first round because they were in ambush. I wasn't paying attention. It's been a while since I've used the tentacles and the Hungry Dead. That is my bad. Tentacle, the order of, because tentacles only have initiative of 3.
And the Hungry Dead were in ambush. So that first round, the Hungry Dead would have attacked Joseph before he got to go. Not the tentacles going before Joseph. So they move in. They are void, so they have an extra die of combat. So they are 4 dice each. We'll roll them separate. Because if he's wounded, he's moved. So we'll start here. We'll work our way around. And sixes, ignore. And they hit on 4 plus. Okay. Next one. One hit. Next one. 2 hits. And the last one. 3 hits. 2 of which. Okay. So Joseph gets defense against some of these. That was not effective. That was not effective. That was not effective. That was not effective. So his defense didn't do diddly squat to those. Unfortunately, they're 5 damage each. Okay, let's just do defense. So this is 5 damage each. So here is 10 dice from this first guy. Luckily, this is a new round, so Joseph's armor still gets to apply. So let's put his over there. And then this is 5 dice. That's good. Okay. All right. I'm gonna run. Have to dip into some more dice here because I just don't have enough. Okay. There's some armor saves. Okay, well, that is still going to be a lot of damage, but he's got his free reroll from the tribal armor, which he will use. That kind of reroll is not very good. Okay, so